Hi, this is Steve Perry of Journey, and I'll be on the Robert Climbs.
You bet.
Okay. Along with Tim Curry and live performances by Jimmy Mack on the Robert Klein Radio Show.
You bet.
Okay. Right here on this station. I hope you'll be listening.
By the way, for those of you listening on radio, I hope there are a few of you there. It was just Jimmy Mack alone. The jumpers are actually one of those mambo machines that you turn on and goes, oompa, pa, oompa, 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 pa, oompa. No, they were real. They looked like they were having a wonderful time, didn't they, Tim?
Yeah, they did.
And we had a wonderful time listening to them. My next guest has a wonderful time, too. One of the most enthusiastic rock and roll stars and composers I've ever met. He really loves his work, and he's so good at it. We welcome Steve Perry from Journey. Welcome,
Steve. It's nice to be here.
I read some things about that. You really love just performing, going on the road. It's sort of like your lifeblood, you say.
Yeah, we go on the road for about 9 months out of a year, and it's a long time to be away from square one.
Uh-huh. Let me ask you, do you take the soap at the Holiday Inn?
No, I don't take the soap.
Uh-huh. Because I feel that it's not, you know, right anymore to take the towels.
I take the towels, though.
I don't. I think the towels are ready. That's not fair. I have towels. But I think the soap is... And I think a bathing cap is mine, I think. What do you think? No,
I don't take the soap.
Not the soap, huh?
No.
I don't like when soap is too big. By the time soap... It's almost
it's not
gone.
Not in Holiday Inns.
Huh?
It's not in Holiday Inns anymore.
No, they have only small soaps there.
This is true.
In fact, I give you... They're getting cheap. The maid cuts off a shaving. Here you are. Like in wartime. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I was just wondering something. The marvel of radio is one thing that the people can't really see what you look like, you know.
Right.
But the people here in the audience can see what you look like. And they've all been looking at these wonderful pink high heels you've been wearing. And it's just something that the people out there should know, you know. It's a nice thing. They look great. I mean, they match.
I feel secure in my masculinity. Enough. That when I saw a gorgeous pair of pink mules, and they were only $9.99, I couldn't resist.
I don't blame you.
You're wondering if I really have them. The answer is yes, I do. That's how we've been getting the laughs. Actually, your shoes are pretty interesting themselves. Hold them up to the microphone.
Can you see these right here?
These were stolen from one of Santa's elves.
Yeah.
They are, I'll describe them for you at home, they're Taiwanese booties made of, maybe a man-made fiber, but they breathe. They're a little, they're
nice. So I can be seeing the
comfortable shoes. Yes. And they're practical, too.
They're
practical.
They're very warm.
You live in San Francisco now?
San Francisco area, yeah. Just moved there.
You didn't even have a kind of bass until recently, isn't that so?
How do you find out all this stuff? This guy's pretty slick.
There's a woman with a tremendous sign in the back. He didn't have a bass till recently.
Oh, I see. No, I was on the road.
Well, I read up on you.
I was on the road for at least almost 3 years and then just decided to get a place about 8 months ago in San Francisco.
Well, where would you actually stay when... Where are you from? Are you from Northern California?
I was born and raised in the central San Joaquin Valley of California, a small town of Hanford, near Bakersfield. Everybody knows where Bakersfield
right.
is.
Right. A lot of lettuce there?
There's a lot of cotton.
Cotton?
You know, a lot of cotton, a lot of
funny,
alfalfa.
When you think of cotton, you think of way down upon. Out there, you think of more lettuce.
All kinds of cotton, isn't
it? Is it edible cotton, or they use it for...
No, it's the type that you wear usually.
Cotton candy to go
cotton
there?
Candy that grows there. It's nice. It's nice. They save it for the fairs, though, usually, you know.
Cotton candy is the most unsubstantial thing. It's a sort of metaphor for life. When you were a child, you take a bite of cotton candy and go, oh, boy, it's beautiful. Now, where is it? Where is it? You know, it defies its own, it's physically impossible, like a dachshund, you know. But, I mean, when you literally were on the road for 3 years.
Yeah.
You made an interesting point, which I think is true, that the road is a good place to create. I'm paraphrasing you, but I mean that it's a way that you can really concentrate. You'd be isolated, not in your regular circle of friends or home.
Yeah, a lot of hotels hanging out, you know, hiding out sometimes, you know.
Yeah.
Forces things to happen.
You also went through personnel changes. Tim Curry has always been Tim Curry. Yeah. Tim Curry replaced Tim Curry in the in the organization, but then Tim Curry replaced him.
Yeah, it was an identity crisis.
Yes. In a band.
Me, myself, and I, right there. Yeah.
You started off with some guys who had been in Santana?
Right, Neil and Greg Raleigh were the founding members. Well, Greg Raleigh was a founding member of Santana, and then Neil Sean came into the group.
Mm-hmm.
And since then, we have gone through two changes. Ainsley Dunbar left the group 2 years ago. And recently, Greg Raleigh just announced that he wants to stay at home, stay off the road, mm-hmm. get married, which he just did,
mm-hmm.
Raise a family, which I'm sure he's working on at this moment, mm-hmm. you know, produce people, the groups, and I believe he's going to do a solo album sometime in the future with Carlos, since they don't have to, similar to the McGuinn thing, they don't have to tour anymore if you don't want to, you know, yeah. Now just more fun. Than anything.
Are you all, the rest of you, understanding of it, or do you want to kill him?
No, no, it's totally, you know... A real smooth thing. We had a tribute party to Greg, and even Ainsley showed up. We had a great time, and
really?
It's really the best thing for everybody because he's really happy, and we're real happy
mm-hmm.
for him.
So what will you replace him?
We're replacing him with a gentleman by the name of Jonathan Kane, who plays guitar, sings, and plays keyboards, who was in the Babies.
Mm-hmm. And for a short stop and a draft choice to be named later. It is an interesting shift there.
Yeah.
But... normally, it's top-rate personnel because they're proven...
Well, right. The Babies were on the road with us for quite some time mm-hmm. on the 1980 tour, which we recorded the Double Life Captured, which is out now.
Right? Oh, yes.
She saw it. I guess there's one person here.
The album is Double Life Captured,
Captured,
and it's all live performances.
With exception of one track, The Party's Over, which is a studio track song.
Well, how did it turn out? You did a lot of them. Are you satisfied?
Yeah, very satisfied. Mm-hmm. I mean, most...
What's the trade-off? What's good and what might be a difficulty?
I'll be honest with you. We waited for quite some time. We recorded a quarter of 200 dates to make sure that we wouldn't have to do any vocal overdubs, because most groups do vocal overdubs, and there's a few groups out on the market right now. I won't mention any names, but...
Ahead,
I mean, if you... No, yeah, really good for my career mention things. But if you listen to the albums, you'll probably find out it sounds very similar to the album you initially bought. You know, and you kind of think there's no big difference. But the reason that happens is because they go back and fix the vocals. And we decided we wouldn't do that. We would capture exactly what it was. So we had to record a good quarter of 200 dates to really find where the enthusiasm was with there in the band, the enthusiasm with the crowd and everything. So it took a while.
That's a way to go. Imperfections or little things.
Human things are better than this mm-hmm. perfection. It gets too glazed.
We were talking over Sarda Furton, my producer. We were talking about that. We think that it's going to happen as huge. I mean, the band is doing extremely well. I'd say it's fair to say that you're more popular in the western half of the country, huh?
It's really true.
Yeah, I think that's changing. I think
the live album is creeping in here mm-hmm. to New York. I'm a new kid in town, but it's like it's becoming quick to find out that we do exist. And the live album has more aggression to it that the band has now, and I think that'll come across in many more markets.
We want to make you welcome. We want to make you comfortable. Take his wallet. We want to make it. Where is your hotel? Want to buy the Brooklyn Bridge? We'll show some more discourtesy to people from other lands and cities when we return after this word. Stay tuned for more. Back on a laugh again. It's a cheap laugh. This time I put straws in my ears and blackened my tooth with a Black Crow chewy candy. Remember those? We're talking to Steve Perry, Journey, and on my right is Tim Curry. You all know out there, Frank N. Furter, Dr. Frank N. Furter,
right.
From the Rocky Horror Show, who is currently starring in Amadeus on Broadway as Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, a great actor. By the way, if you're going to... Anytime you could possibly see this, I think. It has a lot of relevance, even for rock musicians. It's not a question of even being a big Mozart fan.
I mean, I don't lock myself
up. You were promised discourses.
I'd like to come and see your show, you know.
You once said, I'm nervous off stage, I'm comfortable on stage. Is that really true?
Did I say that?
That's what someone said. I think it was Circus or...
That's
we got a quote.
That's probably pretty true, yeah.
Very interesting. I've never heard that. I mean, I've heard...
After the first tune, a chord is struck, it sort of calms down, but there's that anticipation. It's a little bit edging.
But you don't seem nervous now. You're on stage.
No, no.
In a technical sense, we're on a stage here. In a very real sense, we're on a little stage here. We're in a recording studio, but you really love to perform, don't you?
Oh, I really love to perform.
Yes, it's wonderful. Your own songs come out.
My own songs. It's a wonderful business we're in, Robert. Did you know I used to work on a turkey ranch?
You did?
That's a true story.
Let me ask you something. I want to know all about that because I love turkeys. Tell me about it.
Seriously.
They are the dumbest animal of them all time, right?
You know about turkeys.
Yes.
They're disgusting.
One goes, wum, 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 and they all go, wum, wum, wum.
You know. You do know.
I love to tell them. Tell us.
No, it's true. I mean, I used to work with my stepdad when bands would break up and all that. I would go back and work with my stepdad. One time he had a job repairing the turkey sheds. Because they blew away the area from the winds. Nevertheless, I used to hit the hammer on the turkey shed once, and at the same time, 80,000 birds would raise up and go, blah, blah, like you said, you know? And this would, I mean, it wasn't like just one and they'd get used to it,
yeah.
You know, and not do it anymore. All the guys here beating on the hammer, you know, they mm-hmm. wouldn't get used to it. Every time.
Mm-hmm.
Every time you'd hit it. I mean, this would be an 8-hour day, they'd do it. And I'm not kidding you, I went mad, almost went mad.
It's funny, I too am an appreciator of turkeys, as you are. But I kind of...
If one looks up in the rain,
yeah,
they'll all look up, and they breathe through little things in their beak there, they'll drown.
They're very dumb.
It's true.
But,
And there's mutant birds, too. Do you know that? 80,000 birds, there's got to be a couple of mutant birds.
Oh, we had a mutant bird last Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
One leg was out here, the other one was down here. You kidding? This turkey was getting a pension check from the government before it was traded. But I thought that trait that you named at first, I thought that's smart.
What was that?
Who the hell wants someone banging on your house?
Oh, well,
get out of here.
I was trying to fix their house so the rain wouldn't come in so they wouldn't drown.
Well, I think you're asking too much intellectually of them to know. Oh, it's just the carpenter and his son. You know,
that's true.
They have a brain the size of a very small marble. They're lucky they can walk. You ever seen a live turkey or many of them, Tim?
No, just one or two. I've been in several.
Yeah. I've recorded a few myself. Yeah.
They are extraordinary animals. One does it and they all follow.
It's true.
And it's frightening. I made a speech in front of them once.
They will. Listen, you can. They start when you get 80,000 birds together and they all do it together. You start hearing words.
This was in Vermont.
Yeah.
And it was Mr. Neshaw on Lake Champlain. He owns a turkey ranch.
Yeah, yeah.
And my friend used to rent a little cabin there, and I was visiting them. And I stood in front of them. There must have been several thousand turkeys. Yeah. And I go, all right, you turkeys.
And they pay attention,
they,
right?
Right. They stop for a second. They look at you. And then one goes, wow, 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 wow. Another one goes, wow. And they all go, wow, 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 wow.
It's true. It really is true.
And which happened to me at a few concerts. Off, off, off. Off, off. May have an opening. No, I just... what was the idea behind saying that this one will do live? Can you really capture it?
Well, the idea of doing it was because the group goes through a whole metamorphosis when it writes the tunes, records them in the studio, and then turns around and goes on the road, another thing takes shape. You know, in all arts, after you do it so many times, you either get through boredom or whatever, you start to just expand on it. And it either gets better or worse. In our case, we thought it got a lot better and more interesting, you know. And
I heard Any Way You Want It on each version.
Oh, you heard both.
And I there's definitely a difference, of course. And but that's for sure, huh?
Yeah, it's like it's in so many ways. It's like they're both good, but they're both different.
Surely there will be a next time.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to do something different? Do you want to continue in what you're already doing that people like very
no,
much?
No, we're
well, you just do what happens.
Yeah, we do that. We have to be happy as a unit. We have to keep changing. We don't, you know, step into something because that's a thing we should do, or someone walks up and says, boy, I think you guys should go here because it's the thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be ourselves, win, lose, or draw, you see, and maybe that's one of the reasons why we are, you know, like, you know, haven't broken certain markets and have broken other markets, because we won't pull into a certain vein when certain veins are so popular, you
right.
know. So we have to be ourselves as a group to stay as a group and be happy, so we keep writing our own tunes and... hoping everybody likes them as much as we do. Luckily, in most markets, that's the way it is.
Another thing that reminds me of is that you compose Yeah. A good many
Everybody
of his
does.
Songs. Yeah.
I do too.
But I think you're very modest, too, because I think that, you know, I think you stand, you're sort of, your vocals, people are well aware of them. It's, and you're a modest man in that you feel like you're really part of the ensemble.
Yeah, I am. I'm
Which you are, of course.
I'm in the group, though. I mean, it's not.
Right.
At most groups at this point in time, you know, the lead singer would say, okay, thank you, bye, and say, I'm going to do a solo album or something, you know. But no, I'm part of the group. I am in the group, you know.
So I mean, you emphasize that. We're going to come back in a moment to say goodnight to you, and we have a parting thought and a special surprise. What the hell does that mean? We'll be back shortly. Don't go away. Thank you very much. And thank you. We had a wonderful, wonderful evening of a lot of fun and some wonderful rock and roll. I want to thank Steve Perry.
Thank you.
And my best regards to Journey. The new album is Double Live Captured.
Right.
And it's, you can tell the care that's gone into it by what he said. And I loved it. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Tim Curry on my right. Multi-talented Tim Curry. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. And Jimmy Mack and the Jumpers for the live performance.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jimmy. Good night out there. We'll see you next week. Good night.